Hello everyone, hope you're doing good. Today I'd like to talk a little bit about playing lead guitar in reggae music and how I do it in my band and here in the studio. When you're lucky, you have two guitar players in your band and the two parts split up into rhythm and lead guitar. So, as a rhythm guitar player, to my understanding, you basically and only play the chop. The lead guitar player would do everything else. One very important thing is playing the stuck line or the tenor line. So what you do is you follow the bass line in kind of a muted fashion. I mute the strings down here with my right hand and you play short notes like. So you either follow the bass line or you play something that accompanies the bass line, like in Bob Marley's Could You Be Loved. So about the technique, what I do is I hold the pick in a certain way. When I would be strumming or playing a chop, I'd hold it like this and strike down. But when you play the tenor guitar or the stuck line, I turn the pick so it stands out like this, so I can play faster. What I try to do is always play a downstroke when I'm playing the stuck line. It creates a certain sound that I prefer. So for instance, only downstrokes would sound like this. Down and upstrokes would sound like this. Depending on the track or the song, you can either play clean or you use a wah-wah pedal. Then you have certain techniques what you can use. You can add a little slur to your playing. So if the bass line would be, you could go another kind of a slur that many guitar players use is you slide into the first note of the bass line, which will sound like this. Even more effective with a wah-wah pedal, which sounds like this. With my Gibson guitar here, I'd like to use the middle position, both pickups, so I can achieve a fat sound, which is not too bulky or not too thin. Thanks everyone for watching. If you have any questions, just put them in the comments and I will answer them. Subscribe to the channel. Have fun with reggae music. Practice.
Drop the music, let him soar.